Brace yourselves, America. Donald Trump has just unveiled a plan so bold it's sending shockwaves through the political establishment. They're calling it Operation Aurora, and it's not for the faint of heart, but that's not all, folks. We've got exclusive intel on Trump's new cloak and dagger routine. We're talking decoy planes, split motorcades, and unmarked jets. The Donald has gone full stealth mode, and we've got to ask, what is he preparing for? Well, the left is screaming. The right is cheering, and we've got the inside scoop. Now, check this out. Are you listening? As Trump ramps up security and plans to shake the nation with Operation Aurora, smart Americans are securing their wealth with something equally stealthy, gold. Our country is facing massive changes, and the national debt has exploded past $35 trillion. Meanwhile, gold has surged beyond $2,400 an ounce. While Trump travels incognito, smart money is moving into what the Constitution calls real money. Gold and silver. If you've got funds in a low interest account or a 401k or IRA called Global Gold Investments, the number's on the screen. 888-700-4148. Mention Next News for a free 2024 Protect Your Wealth and Retirement Guide and complimentary portfolio analysis. There's also a link in the description, iragoldproof.com. Remember, in times of uncertainty, gold is your silent guardian. Now, what is going on? So, Operation Aurora was announced. President Trump announcing Operation Aurora in Colorado, which will force the removal of illegal migrant members of the violent Venezuelan gang, TDA. This is huge news. Huge news. At the same time, we are learning that Trump is amping up his security. More threats ensue. Remember that story we broke like a week ago where there was... they said there was missiles like that were smuggled across the border, and the goal was to shoot down Donald Trump's plane. Well, it seems as though Donald Trump is taking that threat very seriously, and here is Jack Posobiec with more.
He's had to cancel. Number one, President Trump, this is the headline out of the Washington Post right now, massive, massive article. President Trump has requested military aircraft and vehicles amid threats to his campaign. The FBI has not ruled out that Iran may be involved. We're also seeing, buried deep within this, President Trump has now been traveling with additional decoy planes and dividing his motorcade at times and putting Trump in nondescript planes that do not have his name on the side instead of his longstanding 747 jet due to these security concerns. This, of course, Trump Force One. We're also hearing that that President Trump's campaign has had to cancel recent public events at the last minute due to a lack of personnel from the Secret Service, instead only putting Trump in a small room with reporters rather than a public event. Also, we're getting news from President Trump. I got this from a Trump campaign official. It's coming hot and heavy here, folks. I'm just giving to you as I receive it. President Trump also plans to announce Operation Aurora today at his rally in Colorado. What he's doing is that he announces that he will, as president, invoke the Alien Enemies Act to deploy federal assets immediately against Tren de Aragua and migrant criminal networks operating within the United States, that he will invoke the Alien Enemies Act. This is all coming fast.
So, yes, that was actually, so he's made the promise. He's made the promise that once he is in office, he is going to invoke this act. Here he is.
In honor of Jocelyn Nungari, Lakin Riley, beautiful Lakin, Rachel Morin, and all of the others that are dead and or mortally wounded at the hands of migrants who should never have been allowed into our country, I'm announcing today that upon taking office, we will have an Operation Aurora at the federal level. To expedite the removals of these savage gangs, and I will invoke the Alien Enemies Act of 1798. Think of that. 1798. This was put there. 1798. That's a long time ago, right? To target and dismantle every migrant criminal network operating on American soil. Who would have ever thought that a president or a future president would ever have to stand here and say such things? Who would think that that's even possible to have to do? So many things are changed in the last 4 years, but that's the state of our country now after Kamala and Joe Biden have just absolutely destroyed our country.
So I'm going to break down what exactly Operation Aurora is and what this Alien Enemies Act stands for. But let's continue with some of the remarks still from Colorado.
Because in Aurora, multiple apartment complexes have been taken over by the savage Venezuela prison gang known as Tren de Aragua. Or is your law enforcement and law enforcement all over the world? They know them all over the world. They're a savage gang, one of the worst in the world. And they're getting bigger all the time because of our stupidity. They're known as TDA. TDA. TDA has killed 7 people today, sir. Last month, 6 men with armed rifles and many other men standing right outside waiting for them and handguns were caught on camera as they were forced into a situation, and they said they were forced. They weren't forced. They got their way into an apartment building. They threatened the tenants at gunpoint. These are people that never saw anything like this. These are people that never experienced criminals and crime. They burst into the building and they held tenants at gunpoint and at knife point. 10 minutes later, they opened fire on a 25-year-old man outside the building, fatally shooting him. Of the barbaric thugs who have been identified, at least 3 are illegal aliens who were in Border Patrol custody. They were in custody. By the way, 4 years ago, we had the safest border in the history of our country. Put up that sign, please. Put up my all-time favorite graph. Put up my all-time favorite. Get that put up. That is the most beautiful graph I've ever seen. It's the most beautiful piece of paper I've ever seen. I take it home every night and I sleep with it and I kiss it. Oh, I kiss it. Boo boo. Because without that sucker, I wouldn't be here right now. So if you think about it, Mr. Pastor, great job you did, Pastor. If you think about it, illegal immigration saved my life. I'm the only one. Usually it's the opposite. It's usually the opposite. Thank you very much. But you see that arrow in the bottom? That's when I left. That's the day I left office. You had the lowest number of people coming into our country in the history, recorded history of our country. And then look what happened, like a rocket ship. And they were rough, the ones that came in. We were very, very careful. We were remain in Mexico. We checked everybody out. People came in, but then they got rough because then they said, let's do open borders. Let's let the whole world. And as soon as they did that, jails were emptied, mental institutions were emptied. And I would have done the same thing if I were in charge of any of the many countries we're talking about. 3 of these thugs were in Border Patrol custody, but were released into the United States by Kamala.
So Operation Aurora will be in full effect when he takes office. Now, here's a short
person, clip. But my message today is very simple. No person who has inflicted the violence and terror that Kamala Harris has inflicted on this community can ever be allowed to become the president of the United States. We're not going to let it happen. But my message.
So, President Trump, this has been, he's been talking about this for a while. If you recall, he brought this up with Sean Hannity, I believe.
What did you do? We came from 22 people recently came from the Congo in Africa. Where do you come from? Prison. What did you do? We refuse to say. We're letting everybody in. We're letting everybody in. Take a look at Aurora in Colorado, where Venezuelans are taking over the whole town. They're taking over buildings, the whole town. And the sheriff, who can blame them? I mean, they have AK-47s. You saw it the other day. They're knocking down doors and occupying apartments of people. The people are petrified. And it's getting worse and worse. You look at New York, Chicago, Los Angeles. And now you look at all over the place. You take a look at Iowa, Idaho, places that never had the problem. They're pouring in. 21 million people, that's bigger than New York. And we have to stop it. And we have to do the largest deportation in the history.
Oh, yeah. It's going to be huge. So let's break it down. President Trump vows to unleash the Alien Enemies Act, once reelected as Operation Aurora. The 1798 law grants him sweeping power to detain and deport foreign criminals, starting with gangs like Venezuela's Tren de Aragua. His boldest move yet. So let's dive in to what we can expect from this. Now, the Alien Enemies Act grants the president sweeping authority to act during wartime or national emergencies. So let's just say he declares the border invasion a national emergency. Trump plans to use it to go after criminal networks like Tren de Aragua and MS-13, who have exploited our weak borders for too long. So what does the Alien Enemies Act do? It allows the president to arrest, detain, or deport foreign nationals from enemy nations. But here's the kicker. Trump is extending its use to gangs wreaking havoc on American communities. Venezuela's Tren de Aragua has turned parts of Colorado into crime zones. Trump's decision to use the Alien Enemies Act means these violent gang members can be removed immediately. No lengthy trials and no bureaucratic delays. This law has been around for over 200 years, used during wartime to protect Americans. Now Trump will use it to stop foreign-born criminals embedded in U.S. soil from spreading terror. Finally, action that puts Americans first. Tren de Aragua is no small-time gang. They've infiltrated cities, running trafficking and drug operations. Under the Alien Enemies Act, they will be treated as enemy combatants, not just criminals, making deportation swift and certain. The act cuts through the legal red tape. Foreign gang members from groups like Tren de Aragua and MS-13 won't be able to hide behind legal loopholes. They'll be detained and sent packing, no appeals. This is war on criminal networks, he is declaring. He's not playing games. He's sending a message to every illegal immigrant criminal network. Your days of exploiting America are over. The Alien Enemies Act is his weapon to take them down, starting with Colorado. Under this law, Trump can act without waiting for Congress or the courts. Foreign nationals tied to criminal activity can be rounded up fast, and it's a power no president has fully unleashed until now. For too long, we have watched as criminal gangs like Tren de Aragua flooded our communities. Local law enforcement's been powerless, but Trump's plan to invoke the Alien Enemies Act changes the game. America will not be a playground for these criminals. So what's next? Trump's targeting Colorado first, making no mistake. This is just the beginning. Criminal networks, foreign nationals tied to violence, anyone who threatens American safety is in the crosshairs now. The Alien Enemies Act gives the president more authority than you think. It's not just about deportation. Trump can detain gang members, restrict their movements, and remove them from U.S. soil without interference. Expect backlash for sure. The media and the rabid left will scream unfair and racist, but we know what's really unfair. Criminal gangs like Tren de Aragua tearing apart our cities while politicians do nothing. Trump is doing what no one else has the guts to do. This law was designed to protect America during times of crisis, and right now, with violent gangs taking advantage of open borders, we're in a crisis. Trump's invoking of the Alien Enemies Act is exactly what we need. Make sure you follow our account for updates as Trump leads the charge against these illegal immigrant criminal networks. Tren de Aragua and MS-13 will soon learn what happens when America fights back. Stay informed and join the movement. So this is a huge development. It was a big story today. And no doubt the media is going to just freak. They're going to call this racist and everything else. But the bottom line is President Trump is doing this to protect our country. He's been talking about this. He's been watching what's been going on with Aurora in Ohio, Springfield, Ohio. Help is on the way. Trump announces his mass deportation operation will begin with Aurora and Springfield. This is an invasion from within. We have to get these people out of here. So there you have it, folks. Operation Aurora, Trump's master plan to rid America of criminal gangs, all while he's playing a high-stakes game of hide-and-seek with his own security detail. It's bold, it's controversial, and it is pure Trump. But here's what I want to know from you. It's a sudden increase in security. Is it because of those missiles that were supposedly smuggled across the border? Is it preparation for Operation Aurora? Is something bigger on the horizon? And what will be the fallout if Trump pulls this off? You know the media is going to go crazy. So the comment section is open, and we want to hear from you. Drop a thought.